The solemn nature of this ceremony also makes us think in broad terms about what that sacrifice meant. The names on this monument and monuments all across our country are the names of men and women who gave their tomorrow for our cadets. And we should never take that for granted because of how awesome it is in the enormity of that statement and what it means. It means that someone was willing to write a check up to and including their life to defend our American way of life. And for us, the greatest way we can honor those patriots is to not worry about whether you're a Democrat or a Republican, whether you're white, whether you're black, whether you're Catholic or Protestant. It's to ignore the hyphens that come in between our names and realize that we're all Americans. We're all Americans. And those patriots, when they stood in foxholes and trenches and on pulpits, they didn't ask the person next to them, were you a Democrat, were you a Republican? What color are you? I can't do this, I can't do that. They made the ultimate sacrifice in selfless defense of neighbors and people they will never know, never see.
It's us as we've got the freedom that we have today. When you see what all the other countries are going through and how their way of life is, why would you never not want to be here?
Without the freedom that we have, we wouldn't be here today watching the parade, watching honoring soldiers and Navy and all that.
It's definitely remembering those that made the ultimate sacrifice, and it also was remembering those family members that have served and have kept that memory with us.
Everything, you know, they need to be recognized.
It's always been a part of our life and part of our tradition, being a patriotic American. And even though I myself couldn't fight, I honor those who could fight for me.
I think that we actually
thank the veterans. I think it's wonderful that these people risk their lives so that we can be here today to watch this beautiful parade. And we just thank all of the families and the fallen and everything. God bless them.
Just remembering the ones who have fallen and remembering who served now.
Happy Memorial Day!
you! Hurry up! Take it too long! You're taking too long!
fan of the line.
Almighty and awesome God, we thank you for creating this world and these people, and for entrusting us with caring for your creation. We are thankful that we live in Delanco and the surrounding communities. Lord, we especially thank you today for the men and women who have given their lives for their country. They have paid the supreme sacrifice for freedom for all. We ask your presence with the families, friends, and loved ones of those who are no longer with us, that they may know their loved ones will always be remembered and appreciated for what they have done. We ask that you, O God of wisdom, would guide the leaders of all nations around the world to find ways to live in peace and to work toward ending poverty, disease, hunger, thirst, homelessness, and persecution. Grant that we may do our part in promoting peace and loving our neighbors in our own communities. May we all find comfort and strength in you, gracious Lord. We thank you for all your gifts and blessings and ask these things in your holy name. Amen.
Whereas Fred McQueen has delighted the children and Delanco families for many years through his unselfish devotion as Delanco's very own real-life Santa. And whereas Fred McQuaid, Mr. Santa, was recently featured in the Burlington County Times for his work and enjoyment that he brings to children of all ages during the holiday Christmas season. And whereas Fred McQuaid is an inspiration to all who know him. And whereas it is fitting and proper to officially recognize this magnificent gentleman to celebrate all that he has given to the families and residents of our community. Now therefore be it proclaimed that the members of the Township Committee of Delanco, Burlington County, New Jersey, on behalf of the citizens of Delanco, do hereby express our sincere appreciation and the happiness of wishes to a fine gentleman and resident, Mr. Fred McQuaid, our Santa.
Truly blessed. And I have to thank everyone for participating. And it's a true honor to be your grand marshal. Just thank you, everyone.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Memorial Day was originally called Decoration Day. The reason it was called Decoration Day is because after the Civil War, people would decorate the graves of the dead with flowers. They would actually have picnics there too. And so it became quite a big remembrance. Then later, and there's debates about this, but over the years, many towns started to call it Memorial Day in remembrance. Congress actually officially declared it Memorial Day when it was adopted after a presidential proclamation in 1966. I'd like to tell you about the poppy I'm wearing here on the left. You've probably seen poppies sold at stores by veteran members of different organizations. The poppy is about what occurred at Flanders Field in 1915. It refers to poppies that were growing among the graves of the soldiers, and it has become a symbol of remembrance. I'd like to read part of this poem. In Flanders fields the poppies blow, between the crosses, row on row, that mark our place, and in the sky, the larks still bravely singing fly. Scarce heard amid the guns below, we are the dead. Short days ago we lived, we felt dawn, we saw sunset glow. We were loved and loved, and now we lie in Flanders fields. Remember them. We all know someone from a family or a spouse or a friend of a friend that has been lost in a war. Remember them and their sacrifice all the time, not just today.
In the long history of this great country, men and women have stepped up to serve and protect the freedoms this country was founded upon. When the bell rang, these brave Americans answered the call. Too many paid the ultimate price. It is our solemn duty to never let those who paid the ultimate price be forgotten. Delanco has had many serve. Three memorials stand here today and remind us every day that the price of freedom is not free. Take a moment, pause at these memorials, and give thanks to them. Thank a veteran for their service. Help a military family in your neighborhood. Volunteer to serve your country any way you can. never forget our veterans.
Let us take a moment of silence in gratitude for this country, for the state, for the township, for this town, and for those who gave their lives up so that we could have this freedom. Now may the Lord bless you and keep you. May the Lord make his face shine upon you and be gracious to you and give you peace. May the God of hope fill you with joy and peace. Serve your God with patience and passion. Be deliberate in acting your faith and in love for your neighbor. Be steadfast in celebrating the Spirit's power, and may the peace be your way in this world. Amen.
Everybody, please join me with pride and open hearts in singing our national anthem, the Star Spangled Banner. Oh, say can you see by the dawn's early light what so proudly we hail at the twilight's last gleaming, whose broad stripes and bright stars through the perilous night, o'er the ramparts we watched, were so gallantly streaming, and the rocket's red glare, the bombs bursting in air, gave proof to the night that our flag was still there. Oh, sweet as that star-spangled banner yet wave o'er the land.